Hello, my friends, Rune again. I thought, okay, it's been a while since I tested my Tippmann TCR, Tactical Combat Rifle, paintball gun or paintball marker. I have put on the 14-inch Pathfinder barrel from Tippmann. It's a bit longer than the stock barrel. The stock barrel has a compensator in the end there. So, yeah. I haven't used it for quite some time, so I thought, okay, we will try it today. I have rubber balls, PVC iron balls, aluminium balls, and rubber steel balls. Round balls, all of them. And I have a tin can we can take a shot at. So, Tippmann stopped making this version. It is long been discontinued, but Byrna has obviously purchased the right to make them. So if you want this type of marker today, you can buy the Byrna TCR. So, CO2 canister goes below the rail on the side there. One thing I found problematic with this marker is that it is very length sensitive on the CO2 canisters. There is a small hole here that you can adjust the length of the canister using an Allen key that comes in the pack. I have set it as tight as it can so it won't leak, but we will see. Try it out with Umarex CO2 canister and Crossman Pelican oil on the tip there. I bought this marker back in 2016 and I only used it a few times. So, CO2 canister sits okay in there. Tiny bit of play in the trigger. That is perfect. This marker is not gassed up yet. You need to pull the trigger once to puncture the CO2 canister and then it will be ready to go. I have a 7-shot magazine for it here too, in the stock. It has flip-up sights and it also comes with a pistol grip. I have not bothered putting it on. But yeah, cool thing. Yes, let me load up some shots and we can see how it goes. One moment. So, room temperature is about 20 degrees, 19-20 degrees Celsius. Let's try a couple of shots with aluminium balls, 7.5 gram. Got this from homedefense24.com. Let's take three of those. SMG looking. So, let's hope this thing won't leak any CO2. Puncturing the CO2 canister. Shit, it leaks. Not good. Too bad. Will it still shoot? Yeah, leaks stopped. Here's the ball. And of course I didn't chrono it. Let's take another one. This time with the chrono. And I have a tin can there. $267. ball is still inside. You can see it made a hole there, and it almost made it out the back there. Let's put it up again. .263, gaping hole there, and a dent just below the other place there. Let me try a shot at this side. I hope I didn't lose too much CO2. Let's try PVC iron balls, 10 gram. Three shots. .225. Here's the ball, and it only dented the can. Don't think I bother shooting at this, because there is always a risk of a ricochet. So let me just shoot into the trap there. .218. .203. I think that was the last shot. Yes, it was. Let's try Steel Devils. Load up just a couple. I think the CO2 canister is just about empty. It lost quite a bit of CO2. Guess the O-rings and seals are getting old. .267. These are 6.8 gram. .220. Yes, only two balls, I forgot. Let me just load up a few balls and then empty out the remaining CO2. Three more balls. .163. That one didn't read. No more CO2. Let's try again, since the first CO2 canister leaked out quite a bit. Let's see if it works now. I put aluminium balls inside again. So let's see, no shooting at anything specific. Leaking again. .303.
So let me double check here. It has a small leak there. That sucks. We don't want any leaks. Let's try again. $283. This time it's the aluminium bowl. $265. Should be one more aluminium. $245. Let's try 3.7 gram rubber balls. $379. $330. $297. So I guess it was the leak. I can't hear any leaking now, but clearly it was when I started out with a fresh CO2 canister. What the heck? Let's try it with HPA and see how it goes. I took a whole bunch of drops of the Crossman Pelion oil into the fill valve here, or intake, air intake on the marker. So let's see how it goes. Aluminium balls, let's load up a couple. I used my Tipman HPA tank. I think it has about 850 psi out. It is very clumsy with a big tank, but for those of you that play paintballs, well, maybe it's okay, I don't know. So let's see, aluminium balls, 7.5 gram. Drop the knob. 214. So not exactly screaming fast. Let's try and tighten up the velocity screw. No, that don't work. Then it starts leaking. So, don't get faster than this. If I'm going to open it up and do a PRV delete, I don't think so. $216. and
217.
Okay, that was the aluminium balls. Let's try two shots with the steel devils. These are even heavier, 6.8 gram. It's climbing.
238.
That's interesting. Let's load up a couple of more. Maybe it will get even hotter. Maybe. 230, 234. So yeah, around that velocity. And let's try 3.7 gram. Rubber balls, the lightweight one. $332. Okay, show it to you. $329. I just read the numbers. $332 again. And last shot. $332.
Yeah. So, too bad it had this leaking thing. Could take a few shots, and it made some holes in the tin can with the aluminium balls. So yeah, this marker is old. As I said, I bought it new back in 2016. I have no idea when it's made. So the O-rings and seals might need changing. I don't know. Yes. Okay. Just a little test for you. So, hope you liked the video. Stay tuned for more videos, and thank you for watching.